Let's get to it before there's any more Kett. Andromeda Initiative. We're not here to cause trouble.
So you say. Still haven't told me who you are.
I'm the Pathfinder.
Are you now?
My name's Scott Ryder.
I'm Drak, Clan Nakmore. You'll forgive me if I didn't just trust a stranger from the Nexus. They haven't exactly treated us Krogan well. What are you doing out here?
Checking out these monoliths? The Kett seem pretty interested in this one. Looks like you cleared it out for us, though.
You said I didn't save any for you? Nexus knows shit about the Kett. They think they're safe. But they're just waiting to die out there in space. I've been quads deep on a couple of planets for a while now, taking out Kett bases, fighting ground troops. I know what they can do.
It's not pretty.
You know, we could use a Krogan like you, Drak.
I'm flattered, but do you have any idea how many humans I've watched die? Your meat is spoil. Besides, the day I help the Nexus again is the day the clouds part and the Kett keel over. No offense.
None taken.
Good, because I'm getting bored and the Kett are getting stronger. Seem particularly interested in this alien tech.
Remnant?
Yeah, that. I'm gonna go find more to shoot. Try to keep your head out there.
Tortured. Nexus didn't mention anything about this.
We knew some were lost, Ryder. We weren't told they were left.
Wonder how many are out there.
Too many. Lexi, update Nexus records on Anton, Darren T, and get a recovery shuttle out here.
Good idea. If he's got family, they deserve closure.
We'll give them more than closure. We'll finish what he started.
Radiation levels normal.
Should be enough glyphs. Scott, the monoliths are online and connected to something in the lake. This could be the master switch we're looking for.
I'll meet you there. Don't do anything without me.
Whoa, it's forming a bridge.
Looks solid. If not, prepare to swim.
No. No, this can't be right. All that fanfare for an empty room? There's some secret here. There must be. Do your Pathfinder thing. Oh, you're good.
And I make it look so easy. How far down do you think it goes?
That can't be air pressure. Electrostatic? Gravitation. Oh, you idiot, PB. That wasn't the front door. This is.
I'll let you know. Us.
Embrace the unknown, Ryder. Now this is more like...
Looks like a bunker. Or a vault?
Whatever you call it. The controls for that atmosphere processor might be down here somewhere.
Let's find out.
Anything could be important. Let's be thorough.
Not what we're looking for. But worth getting a record.
You go ahead. I've got your back.
I think that gravity well works in reverse, too.
Then we have a way out.
You're not leaving already, are you?
Not until we find those processor controls. Only minimal power. I don't think it triggered the atmosphere processor, but...
Pathfinder, a conduit beneath the floor just activated. Fluid is running through it. It could be generating emergency power. Your scanner will have more details.
No signs of any cat. Maybe they can't get into the vault.
But you can. That'll get their attention.
Lucky me. I see the conduit, Sam. Whatever it is, leads out of the room. Got anything?
There's Element Zero threaded through all this tech. Imagine the engineering that would take.
Look there, do you see that? It's like a broken information display.
Shouldn't it be warmer this deep underground?
Phrase recovered. Must read to access. This console links to surface facilities.
Then it must control the atmosphere processor.
No glyphs. It looks dead, or locked down, like most of this place.
The fluid conduit leads to this console and further into the vault.
So if we follow that conduit, it might lead to the system lockdown.
These data patterns... Another gravity well, and... That's new.
What is it?
A symbol of authority? A key? It's easy to speculate with Remnant, but we need more facts. I'll see what I can find on this beauty. Maybe over this way.
Whatever has this place on lockdown is that way.
I do my best work solo. You fix up the vault, I'll investigate the relic, and together we'll figure this place out.
Not a bad idea. We'll cover twice the ground.
See? I knew you were smart. I'm on frequency 145.8. Stay safe.
10 credits say she ends up in a pit of spikes.
This gravity well's sealed off. No way through.
Incidentally, a gravity well is the gravitational effect of a large mass in space. This is more accurately a well with variable gravity.
Keep a note for our Asari friend, and for when we try to explain all this.
Comm check. It's... well, you know who.
We read you, PB. Stay in touch. They dug this place through solid rock.
Look up there. Must be how they kept it from collapsing.
What's that liquid?
Unable to classify.
The only way through is down towards it.
There's a low hum through everything here. Can you feel it?
Remnant!
Careful, don't fall in that liquid!
It burned through your shield. Found that out the hard way.
Cover!
Looks like a blast shield. That might be handy.
We're good!
My God.
All this for an atmosphere processor? What is this place?
Another aqueduct. How many do they need?
Are those roads down there?
I can't even see where they end.
Eyes up! Don't let them get above us!
Keep up the pressure! We're almost through!
We're good!
Is that a good idea?
Nothing ventured, nothing gained.
Crap, the conduit's sprang a leak.
Careful! No way you can interface with the console like that.
And no fluid means no power. Damn it. Maybe that's why those devices up above were turned off. We're not turning back now. There has to be some way to fix the leak.
It's breached.
Hey, wait! The observers were using weird laser frequencies to fix a broken wall back there. I can send the frequencies to your Omni-tool. Maybe they can patch up the conduit?
And received. I'll give them a shot.
Those frequencies. Just a patch job, but it should hold.
Nice work. If it's fixed, that console should work now.
Looks like it worked.
There's even a bridge. You're a pal, Ryder.
Where are you going?
We've got to be close to the system lockdown by now. First one gets the glory.
We'll catch up. If we got that door working too.
How do we get across?
That did it. Watch your step. It's still a long drop.
thoughts, Sam?
Unknown, though it appears related to the lockdown. An in-depth study may reveal its purpose. The system lockdown is disabled. The vault and the atmosphere processor should return to full operation.
Ryder, you fixed the lockdown, didn't you? The whole place is lighting up. Power readings are off the chart. Really, really off the chart.
But if it's back online, we should be good. Should we
go? Baby, get back to the entrance now!
I saw it! What is that thing?
Don't risk it, just go!
Wise to escape, Ryder.
I know, Sam!
Console is attempting surface reconnection.
Come on!
Vault restart is now complete.
That was... Talk about a rush!
What was that... field?
Might have been sweeping the vault. Or chasing us.
An immune response? Maybe one last scrub before startup? This place is full of surprises.
We have to be more careful. That field almost disintegrated us.
But it didn't. You want to focus on that or the cool vault you just activated?
Atmosphere processor is online. Recovering last console activity.
Is that the Helios cluster?
Yeah. There we are.
That's Eos.
Whoa. Did restarting the system do that?
If that light is us, then all these points could be vaults in other worlds. Dormant, like this one.
Maybe. But why is there a whole network of them? What's all this for?
This tech can create observers from nowhere, or ravage a whole planet. And that's just what we've seen.
The bots? Those plants back there? The atmosphere processors?
Back home, some corporation hit a desert world with an ice comet. They changed the atmosphere to bring rain.
To help with support life.
That first processor we saw was making things worse, but maybe it malfunctioned.
Is that what these builders were trying to do? Make worlds habitable? Even terraform a whole cluster?
Hey, look there. That's different. Maybe it's active? We've got to go see.
Sam?
Extrapolating. These coordinates lie beyond the space we have currently surveyed, Pathfinder.
Mark it on our charts. We need more to go on. Let's head up to the surface. I could use some fresh air. Look at that sky.
How? No atmosphere processor works that fast.
If this effect is representative, Pathfinder, air and moisture patterns will show noticeable improvement. Eos could support an outpost.
A foothold. That's all we need. Just enough to begin. This remnant technology could be the key to our survival, if we can control it.
You can. Kind of. Still, wouldn't hurt to find a manual.
We've got a lead. Sam marked it on the charts down there. That site is active, whatever it is. Who knows what we'll find there?
We? You want to come along?
I want to know what makes the remnant tick. You've got a key to their technology. Or a crowbar, at least.
I don't know. We're a team. You like working solo.
Sure, but we don't have to be joined at the hip to solve all this. Come on.
All right. Pack what you need and...
Data pad, toothbrush, clean underwear, that'll do. I'll catch up with you.
Well, this will be interesting.
Me.
You could really handle yourself, kid. And I hear you're the one to thank for clearing up the sky. Had your number all wrong.
You're not so bad yourself, old man. Maybe we should work together after all.
This fight was pretty good, but you're still Nexus and green as a drell. Still, something tells me you've got potential. Be ashamed to waste that. I'm in. Just point me to your ship and try to keep up.
This is gonna be great.
The first colonists sent audio logs about these regions back to the Nexus.
And?
Fairwinds Basin.
This is where we'll build our new outpost. A real beginning.
Prepping deployment order. You must choose what purpose this new outpost will serve.
The Nexus doesn't get a say?
Resources are at a crisis point. Protocol states this judgment call falls to the Pathfinder. With current supplies, you could build a military outpost, focusing on defense and militia training. Alternatively, a scientific outpost could advance the initiative's research and discoveries.
What do you think? Military outpost or scientific?
Pathfinder's call, but research is no good if we're dead. Military.
It's got to be science. Our colonists need to understand their home.
Be advised that the first outpost placed by a Pathfinder will be a statement in itself. Fair or not, your choice will represent the initiative and its intentions in Andromeda. Consider carefully.
Prioritize research and discovery. That's our foundation. And our future.
Orders prepped. Ready on your signal.
Andromeda Initiative, this is Ryder. Pathfinder.
EOS is ready for deployment.
Copy that. Outpost block inbound. And ready as hell. August Bradley, operational head for this block. Mayor now, I suppose. We're ready to make the most of what you delivered.
It took a lot of people to get us this far. That's the work you'll continue.
I hear that. Prodromos. That's what we're calling her.
They're eager. I haven't seen eager for months. EOS is far from golden. But now it's a producer. A real and reasonable first step. They think you did the impossible. The Nexus. I warned them, hoping was irresponsible. You proved me wrong, Pathfinder.
What are you playing at? Seems like being my friend is suddenly valuable.
Fair assumption. The reality, Ryder? You bought us time. But one outpost on a long-shot planet won't stop us from starving. You already have a lead on something else?
The nav point from the vault.
Now it gets complicated. The others are ready to officially sanction your efforts, to be a part of your success. We all want the initiative to succeed, but after failing for so long, no one agrees on how to do it. Be aware, that's all.
Watch out for everyone. But not you, right? You're genuine.
I know what I came here to be. Talk to Bradley. Later, we'll go over the extended job of Pathfinder. Until then, Tan's waiting on the Nexus.
Before the meeting gets started, I have bunk assignments for PB and Drac.
Already put my rucksack in the kitchen. I'll hang out there if that's okay.
And I'm in one of the escape pods. More my speed. That's fantastic. Welcome aboard. Any thoughts, Ryder?
This isn't a military vessel, but there need to be rules. Better to ask about protocol. Let's talk about our success on EOS. Besides establishing our first viable outpost, we did some amazing things. We discovered the Remnant and breached their vault.
And didn't get killed.
Overcame radiation poisoning a number of times.
And didn't die.
Confronted by Ket at every turn.
Once again, did not get killed.
You guys really need to raise the bar on what you call success.
Yeah, should we use the Krogan definition of success that got your homeworld nuked by your own people?
Fair enough.
Let's focus. Back to the task at hand. Looking forward.
Exactly. Here's my only question. When do we hit that next vault? It looked active. We have to get on that.
Hang on. We need to not go off half-cocked.
There are initiative priorities. The team calls the shots.
Actually, the Pathfinder calls the shots, just to be clear.
So what do you need from us, Ryder?
Let's be kind and give each other the benefit of the doubt. Finding a home for tens of thousands in this hellscape is stressful enough without adding dysfunction.
You got it, boss.
If Krogan are known for one thing, it's getting along.
But not humility or self-awareness.
Okay, let's head back to the Nexus. PB, Drac, see Lexi for a physical. Good meeting, everyone.
Glad you stopped by. You'll pardon me if I keep an eye on our vector.
That's probably smart.
Nothing like being on the bridge of your very own ship, is there?
I could stand here and drink in that view all day.
When I was test piloting the ship back home, I often did. Of course, it took a whole team to build the Tempest. I was the only one to come to Helios, though.
Why did you?
What can I say? We poured our hearts into a ship that wouldn't realize her potential until Andromeda. I could have stood on the shore and waved goodbye, or took the leap to see how it all turned out.
I like the Tempest, but I'm not sure I'd travel between galaxies for her.
The Unknown Frontier had its charms, too. It's just strange not having the rest of the design team. I remember Serena debugging line 2281 over and over, chewing that green pencil. Tion and O'Connell arguing equations, tapping on the console, 3 drips of coffee on the corner.
You remember all that?
Hmm? Oh, yes. Solarians have photographic memories, and apparently mine's unusually sharp. Like my past is still happening. Though I suppose with the Solarian arc missing, you might not get many chances to compare.
Did you hear anything about the Ark back in the Nexus?
Not a peep. Isn't that strange? You'd think there'd be something. Not that I dislike your company, but it's lonely without other Solarians.
Don't sweat it. We'll bring the Solarians home.
Of course we will. I just have to be patient, that's all. I should get back to it, but thank you. I was afraid the Tempest would be mothballed after we lost your father. We built her for this. She deserves to be in a Pathfinder's hands. Please, come by any time.
Scans of the Scourge. All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid.
I suppose it is a rather darkly beautiful phenomenon.
Darkly beautiful. I like that. Helios is incredible, isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it, so alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
There's nothing about the universe that suggests a divine intelligence. And most of what we've seen in Helios is artificial, as you said yourself.
Yes, but we're creative beings. Whoever made the Remnant was too. Why should that be proof against a god? Wouldn't a true creator want to pass on the drive to invent?
You are welcome to your beliefs. It's good to have different voices on the team.
Excellent. Oh, speaking of the team, I should update the folks back in the Nexus with the latest reports. We'll talk later.
You're setting up in here, huh?
Yeah, I'm going through what we got out of that vault. If I can crack this data storage box, it'll help with a personal project back on the Nexus. This is a nice, out-of-the-way place where I can tinker, and I can sleep anywhere. It's not exactly homey, but I like that about it. Not really looking for a home. Oh, but I will help you find everyone a home. While I'm with you, at least.
Does your brain ever take a breath?
Sorry, not really. Even my dreams are in time-lapse. I get it. You want to know who's on your ship, so you're here to figure out what makes me tick, right?
Something like that? Sure.
Well, I was born in a log cabin on rural Haitiana, to simple but loving parents, just trying to... I look forward, not back, Ryder. Why snooze through my life story? Get to know me out in the field, while we're uncovering the mysteries of this galaxy. That's why I'm here. Got tired of yawning back home.
Tackling complete strangers in the Milky Way wasn't doing it for you?
I think tackling you anywhere would be fun. Did I say that out loud? Life won't be boring with you around. I may never yawn again.
You left everything and everyone you knew because you were bored?
No. I came with someone I knew. Then she got bored with me. Ryder, the Milky Way was so... been there, done that. Even if I hadn't done it, someone had. If there's one thing you should know about me, it's that I live for the unknown. For the never been done.
Well, congratulate yourself. No one has ever so successfully dodged my attempts to get to know them.
Yes! I'm number one! Buy me a drink sometime. Who knows what will spill out of my mouth. Then again, I need remnant scrap. Remtech, I call it. For projects like the one I mentioned, which you're gonna love, by the by. Promise to bring me what you scrounge, and I'll submit to all your questions.
Remtech, huh? You got it.
Pathfinder, making the rounds. Slumming it, huh? Want to see how the riffraff are making out.
Hey, it's a dirty job. Are you the riffraff spokesman?
King, actually. You might want to bow. Otherwise, no telling what might fall off the Nomad when you're out there.
I'll take my chances. Just want to see how things are going with the ship.
I can coax more out of this baby than some might think, but we shouldn't go too far or push too hard between Nexus stops. For now. It just feels good to be stretching our wings, you know? Locked in idle too long, you start to drift. People, same as ships. Stuck on the Nexus, gotta say, I was regretting joining the Initiative.
I doubt you were the only one.
Yes, but it's a new thing for me, regret. I tend to live the way I work. Kind of feel it, do it. Not a lot of close ties. No real sense of purpose. Figured maybe I'd find my true calling in Andromeda. Then I got here and... oops. I just made a decision there's no turning back from. I was going nuts on that station. You can't know how jazzed I was when you showed up.
You mean how jazzed you were that a Pathfinder showed up?
Tomato, potato. You just keep pointing this ship wherever you want it to go, and I'll make sure she can get there. Deal?
Deal.
Oh, hey, Pathfinder.
The Pathfinder's there? Let me say hi.
Fine, but don't embarrass me. Ryder, this is Cid, my sister. Cid, Ryder.
Let me guess. Little sister?
Who are you calling little?
Look, kiddo, gotta go.
Wait, Ryder, I just wanted to know if...
So I know it feels like I just jumped aboard your ship without explanation.
I would have done the same just to get off the Nexus.
That's not why I came. Sure, I want to explore the galaxy, but I'm really here to work. I know everyone on the crew, even the actuators Gil prefers for the ship. Better, I know how to get my hands on them. With me around, your crew's going to be at their best. We've been failing for months, Ryder. Now that we have you, we have a chance out here.
Ability to haggle with the locals? Great. But please tell me you're also good in a fight.
Like I said before, wrangler, provisioner, gunner, and everything in between, I do what I have to. We all have a personal stake in this. If it keeps going the way it's been, we're all dead. I should track down a lead for Gil's actuators. Back channels, you know. We'll chat later.
Pathfinder, help me with something? I know, not exactly standard. Gotta make the space comfortable. Plus, the fabric diffuses the charge from an overclocked omni-blade. Not giving up a 6% boost, right?
Someone brought this to Andromeda?
It was new when we left. It's been a hard year. So, finally time for that beer? And after 2 years and a dozen suspensions, I took a lateral promotion out of the Force. Being a cop just didn't fit. But crisis response? Digging people out of trouble? That worked. I bet Hustle followed you into a few peace actions. Think about your alliance days much?
Tell me about your group.
Heavy Urban Search Terrain 1? Yeah. Earth's contribution to a multi-species disaster response unit. HUST-1, but Hustle looks much better on the patch. All civilians, retired vets, or shits like me. I was fiercely bearded. Tastes better just thinking about those days.
I put it behind me after Dad's work went sour. It was a long time ago.
600 years, give or take. So, Pathfinder, why Andromeda?
That blunt, huh?
That blunt.
When I started with the Alliance, it was about adventure. But with my dad's troubles, staying wasn't going to work. I needed something new. But if I wanted to get away, it had to be this far.
Gotcha. Clean slate. Classic.
Back at you, Costa. Why'd you come?
I want to say I'm running from my past, but really running from myself. That'd be a great story. But it's bullshit. I had family, friends, a good enough job, nothing was wrong. I just heard about the initiative and I believed in it. I believed in a new beginning. Still do. I have to. We're in it.
If it all goes wrong, it could feel like we left for no reason.
I know why I'm here. A bad start can't change that. I won't let it. In crisis response, I'd focus on essentials. That's you and this team. Pathfinder leads to planets, leads to people. You've got your part covered, you've got this. I'll do my damnedest to help with the rest.
You're not Harry.
The blue give it away? Habitat 7 was a little more action-packed than Harry bargained for. He decided to spend his retirement years on the Hyperion looking after your sister.
Happy to have you, Dr. DePero.
I'll do my best. Now, hold still.
Ow!
Sorry.
I remember you having a gentler touch.
Still trying to get my bearings. Thought I'd be waking up colonists, not taking care of the Pathfinder.
I couldn't be in better hands.
I just stabbed you.
We all have off days.
I always hoped to work in the field, but everything's happening so quickly.
Focus on the positive. It helps.
I guess this is my opportunity to study alien species firsthand. Getting a Kett specimen aboard the Hyperion would be difficult, but here...
What?
A Kett corpse. For autopsy, a live subject would be better, but I'm not greedy.
Why do you care about the Kett?
Harry didn't tell you? I'm a specialist in alien anatomy. My thesis on Krogan virility and aggression is what got me in the initiative.
That's a very specific topic.
I grew up on Omega, lots of Krogan mercenaries. The best habitat outside T'Chunka. But we were discussing the Kett. An autopsy could teach us potential weaknesses, average lifespan.
Right.
Just something to think about. Sam, make sure the Pathfinder eats his vegetables.
Don't give the Pathfinder too much trouble. Oh, Roshan.
Who are you talking to?
Kesh, Nexus Superintendent, thinks she can boss me around just because she's my granddaughter.
I like the no-trouble plan. How about we stick with that?
Kesh said not too much trouble, kid. Not no trouble. The Kett makes sure some trouble's always coming for you.
That's not reassuring.
Life out here ain't reassuring. You'll get used to it.
Is that all you brought?
You travel lean when supplies are tight and you're on your own.
Leaving the Nexus can't have been an easy choice.
It was, actually. Staying became impossible. After the mutiny happened, it was either buckle under Tan's rules or start our own colony. Easy choice. Bad consequences all around.
Not all Krogan left. Your granddaughter stayed.
Good thing she did. Without my Roshan, you wouldn't have had much of a station to tie your ship to. As for me, I'm way more useful out here. Lots to shoot at, for one.
Your people come first.
Keeping Kesh and our colony safe will always be my top priority. That's why I'm happy to tag along, help make this galaxy a little more hospitable.
Can't argue with that.
Pathfinder, is it true? We're settling Eos.
We've thought that before.
But Eos is different now, right? Pathfinder.
All right, settle down. Give him space. Lieutenant Syax, Kendros' aide. They all wanted to see you. Real hope again. It's been a while.
They've got a Pathfinder again. This is what we do.
And you've done it splendidly.
Professor Herrick, right?
What you achieve with that remnant vault is unprecedented, Pathfinder. Impossible. But with new scientific talent waking up, we'll unravel those mysteries. The whole Nexus will benefit.
We've taken some hard knocks, but this proves we'll always get up again.
Always.
Well, what are you waiting for? There's a new world out there.
Thank you, Ryder.